today. Go to Xfinity.com/TMOFAX, call 1-800-XFINITY, or visit a store today. Requires paperless billing and auto pay with stored bank account and a 1-year contract. Connect more internet versus T-Mobile home internet. $60 a month. Regular pricing applies after promo period. Restrictions apply. Taxes and fees extra. Actual speeds vary. Effective for new customers after 1/17/2024. T-Mobile's price lock will only reimburse your last bill if you terminate service due to a price increase.
What if the next time you painted your home was the last time you painted your home?
Our Rhino Shield has been on for 8 years.
Rhino Shield. Call 888-RHINO-41. Don't paint, don't vinyl. Go Rhino!
When you're high, you feel different. But if you feel different, you drive different. So don't drive high. Brought to you by NHTSA and the Ad Council.
Good morning.
Good morning.
We've talked the whole night through.
Good morning.
Good morning to you. Good morning. Good morning. It's great.
This is Saturday Night on The Circle on 93 WIPC.
When the band began to play,
welcome back, Indianapolis, to another exciting edition of Saturday Night on The Circle. Happy to return to the airwaves as usual, this time joined by guest producer Corbin. Beep, 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 pushing the buttons and doing the things to make the show function. Now, of course, we are coming hot off of the event of a lifetime, one that won't be seen in Indiana for many more years to come. I'm, of course, referring to the totality solar eclipse, which we all got to experience, and it exceeded in many ways expectations. It certainly lived up to the hype, but not the prophetic portents of doom that many had. I mean, they said it was going to be wall-to-wall traffic. You weren't going to be able to move around. An emergency declaration. People were allowed to stay home from school, take off work. And, I mean, that's fine just to see the spectacle, but not because the traffic was falling apart. I mean, they said that there could be potentially human sacrifices associated with the total eclipse.
Human sacrifice, dogs and cats living together, mass hysteria.
And, of course, that didn't come to be. Some small towns had contemplated buying terrorism insurance for some reason because of the throngs of individuals they anticipated swamping their locales, which ultimately didn't happen. Now, as far as the astronomical phenomenon, that was cool. Producer Corbin, did you have the opportunity to experience totality for yourself?
No, I did not either.
What? No!
That's, I was.
What do you mean, no? What were you doing?
I was right where I am now, producing Tony Katz today on Monday during the eclipse. So, no.
Well, you could have made it outside. That was producer Allison's excuse, because I talked to her on Monday when I was filling in on the Tony Kinnett show, and she said, well, I couldn't because I was doing Hammer and Nigel. And I said, you could have left those rat bastards and let them vamp for a couple minutes and just run out to the balcony. Surely you could have made your way out to the balcony.
I also wanted to beat the traffic. I never seen I-65 so clear.
Right, exactly. So they lied. They lied about the traffic. They lied about the apocalyptic portent. Man, I can't. Oh, that's heartbreaking. I mean, are you into stuff like that? Are you into science? Do you like?
I mean, I look at videos on like YouTube or something, like black holes and the planets and all that. But I'll catch the next one.
No, you won't. The next one's not until like 2094 in Indiana. The one next to that is in Wyoming, and I think that's 22 years from now or 20 years from now in 2044 or 2046. I can't remember which. Anyway, a long time. I'm going to be 51. Well, so yeah, 20 years from now, 2044.
Yeah,
Wyoming. You're going to go to
45.
Wyoming?
I mean, I like Wyoming. I'm a country outdoor guy, so I may be living in Wyoming.
You know, I've never been. I would like to visit. Yeah. What was it like while you were driving on the highway? Did you at least get to experience the darkness?
Oh, it wasn't as dark as people thought it was going to be. Everyone was saying it's going to be completely midnight. You'll see a whole bunch of stars and everything. It looked like a midsummer Indiana sunset.
Yeah.
It got dark, and then the cool thing for me was seeing it start to get light again, because I was hitting the bridge off of Pennsylvania over here in Indianapolis. And then I come out from underneath that bridge, and then all of a sudden, the sun just starts coming back out, and boom, you got sunlight again.
It was spectacular. I watched it from outside my house. I stood in the street for a couple of minutes, and of course, nobody was driving because everybody was looking at the sun, and with our safety glasses equipped, naturally, don't want to damage your eyes. And it was incredible. It was breathtaking, and it was refreshing, if for no other reason than just for a moment. just for a couple of brief minutes, everybody was united in witnessing this spectacle and not harassing each other, shooting each other, or engrossed in politics. It was just, you know, a shared experience. And I feel there are so few of that in modern society.
Very few. It was nice to see on Facebook and social media afterwards, everybody was cheering and happy. You don't get to see that much these days.
Now, there were a variety of reactions to this phenomena, including Marjorie Taylor Greene, who we'd already talked about. She tweeted out,
God is sending America strong signs to tell us to repent. Earthquakes and eclipses and many more things to come. I pray that our country listens.
But she followed that up. She doubled down because that was ridiculous in and of itself, but she couldn't take the L and move on because basically she said that natural phenomena, natural disasters are the result of God's wrath and your sinful behavior. So if a tornado wipes out your small town, it's screw you because you're a sinner, you and your sinful community, and God has smote you with his wrath, which I think is an unhealthy way to view nature. We certainly have evolved since then, since the days of human sacrifice, but not everybody. Marjorie doubled down again and said,
many have mocked and scoffed at this post and even put community notes. Jesus talked about that in Luke 12:54-56. Yes, eclipses are predictable and earthquakes happen and we know when comets passing by. However, God created all of these things and used them to be signs for those of us who believe.
Which in some ways is even more horrifying because what she's saying there is millions of years ago, when God put the planetary motions into effect, he predicted that in 2024, Americans would be sinful more than ever before and need to be warned to repent and vote Republican in the upcoming election. Now, that's some incredible logic, but you know, there were a variety of reactions, like I said, and Marjorie's was not the only outrageous opinion. Sonny Hostin as well had a pretty fascinating theory for the cause of the eclipse. Not God, but a different religious force, that of climate change.
We've got a solar eclipse. We've got
the
earthquake. She ran down the hallway.
The rapture is here.
The rapture's here. And then also I learned that the cicadas are coming.
Cicadas.
Cicadas.
Although I love
for the first time in like 100 years. This is what I read.
Two different kinds of cicadas.
Two different times are coming.
The good cicadas and the bad cicadas.
But for the first time in many, many years.
No, every 17 years this happens.
Well, that's not what I read, but maybe, you know better.
I would say
all those things together would maybe lead one to believe that, you know, either climate change exists or something is really
turning.
Earthquakes are not at the mercy of climate change. It's underground.
It happens. The eclipse, they've known about the eclipse coming because eclipses happen.
Just be wrong. Just stand there in your wrongness and be wrong and get used to it.
So Sonny Hostin's theory is that the geological forces of continental shift and the eclipse itself are attributable to climate change. And of course, she didn't know about the cicada life cycle either. I saw you nodding in agreement there, producer Corbin, with Whoopi Goldberg, who for once got one right. She's right. It's two different broods. One on a 17-year-old cycle. And what's the other?
It's like every like 5 or 6 or 7 years or something like that.
Anyway, it's just for the first time in like 214 years that these are coinciding with one another. Two different broods hatch cycle is now. So Whoopi Goldberg actually knew something for once, which is interesting to have caught in and of itself on The View. But also on full display, scientific ignorance was Sheila Jackson Lee, the Democratic representative from, I think, the 13th district over there in Texas. While she was waiting for the totality to cross over her region, she enlightened the audience with a little bit of talk about the moon and its state. And she believes the moon is comprised of gas.
You have the energy of the moon at night, and sometimes you've heard the word full moon. Sometimes you need to take the opportunity just to come out and see a full moon is that complete rounded circle, which is made up mostly of gases.
Nope.
And that's why the question.
Nope.
The question
nope.
is why or how could we as humans live on the moon? Are the gases such that we could do that? The sun is a mighty powerful heat that is almost impossible to go near the sun. The moon is more manageable.
That's not how it works. That's not how any of this works.
Jupiter, I believe, being the most dense gaseous planet in our solar system. And even then, as dense as Jupiter's concentration of gases is, I don't think you could land on it. Pretty sure. But I'm not an astronomer. I barely passed that course in college. I struggled through that. I was proud to get my C and move on. But that said, even I, with my limited understanding of the universe and its functions, know that the moon is indeed not made of gas or cheese, for that matter. But Sheila Jackson Lee confused on those points. The eclipse was breathtaking. I'm glad I got to experience it. And, you know, Producer Corbin, I might join you out in Wyoming in 20 years because it was worthwhile. Thanks for listening to Saturday Night on The Circle. Stay tuned for more coming up in the next segment. Donald Trump has issued his opinion on Roe versus Wade and in vitro fertilization, a topic which could have a major sway in how the election unfolds in November. We'll tell you more coming up next. Stay tuned to 93 WIBC.
Kendall and Casey.
Now, this spring is here. The seasons and allergies are on upon us. Wow. We're on the rise even more.
So choppy, slurring, that one, or brew beer?
Beer brewed here, it is used to make the brew beer here in this fine. Oh, Earth Rider, thanks for the Great Lakes. I wonder.
What is he even saying?
Well, he sounds buzzed.
Kendall and Casey, weekdays 9 till noon on 93 WIPC and WIPC.com.
Hi, this is Denny Smith, and the allergy season is getting a jump start on all of us, and we really need to get ready to fight back. How about having ZeroRes help you take on dust and dander and allergens and even bacteria in your carpets with a great spring deal? Get 3 rooms ZeroResified starting at just $139 and take $75 off your air duct cleaning to get that true spring cleaning feel. It's unbelievable and kind of scary just how much of the uglies are in our carpets. And it's because those carpets are the largest air filter in the home. The ZeroRes service is easy to line up. You can go online at ZeroResIndy.com. Do the scheduling at your convenience. And don't forget the ZR water difference. No soap, no residue, no harsh chemicals, leaving things really clean. Now mention WIBC, get 3 rooms of carpet cleaning starting at $139. Plus you'll get $75 off the air duct cleaning too. Call 317-388-5141. Or book things online at ZeroResIndy.com.
Sinus pain. You know it all too well. It's constant. It's frustrating. The pressure. The headaches. The snoring. The constant clogged feeling. You're tired of feeling like this, but you've tried nasal sprays, over-the-counter medicines, even home remedies. No matter what you try, nothing gives you lasting sinus relief. You're tired of missing out and feeling miserable. There is something you can do. Something different. Indianapolis Sinus Center. The physicians at Indianapolis Sinus Center have been serving the community with proven treatments for over 50 years. They know what you're going through, and they're standing by ready to offer you the best treatments to provide long-term relief. Breathe better. You don't have to keep suffering from sinus pain. Call Indianapolis Sinus Center today at 317-528-9650 and take the first step toward relief. 317-528-9650. That's 317-528-9650. Or go to IndianapolisSinusCenter.com.
JMV here from SM's Home and Garden in Bargersville. Tropicals are here and ready to sell. The nursery is open with new shipments arriving daily. Miss M's is ready to beautify your garden and yard this spring. Enjoy this spring weather and plan a trip to Miss M's on State Road 135 in Bargersville. Flowers, trees, shrubs, mulch, and more. Miss M's in Bargersville has it. State Road 135 in Bargersville, just south of Whiteland Road. Miss M's Home and Garden.com. Follow them on social media for daily updates.
Imagine having all the money you need for retirement, all the income, every month, guaranteed. That's Secure Future Investor, an indexed annuity tied to growth in the stock market, but without any risk of loss, ever. It's guaranteed money for life income, no matter how long you live. Call 888-509-2228. 888-509-2228. Sponsored by GP Agency, Inc., Raleigh, North Carolina. Licensed in all states. Performance may vary. Consult with your financial professional before making an investment decision.
We all have someone we love, like the favorite lyric in our favorite song. You can't imagine life without them.
Cancer screening tests can help keep the person you love around longer by detecting changes before cancer develops, or catch it early when it may be easier to treat. And many tests are available for free or covered by insurance. It's time to sound like a broken record. Tell all your friends and family, I love you. Get screened. Visit cancer.org/get screened to learn more.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
The Indianapolis Public Library. More than just books. Visit your local branch today.
You're listening to Saturday Night on The Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back to Saturday Night on The Circle. And in a decisive election year where the result could depend on a few thousand votes either way, a few issues could ultimately decide the fate of the election. One of them including the issue of abortion rights, which, of course, since the overturning of Roe versus Wade almost 2 years ago in June of 2022, that has punted the issue back to the states, who are now, in many cases, choosing to allow some access to abortion. We've seen it even in Midwestern states like Ohio, in fact, and deep Southern states like Alabama. In fact, anytime the issue is put to a vote, it seems that the majority of Americans believe in at least some limited access to abortion services. Of course, another part of that discussion is in vitro fertilization, because in the more extreme positions of pro-life that hold any fetus is equivalent to that of an adult human being, that kind of would mean in vitro fertilization clinics are mass murdering serial killers. Because in the process of fertilizing these eggs, they don't just fertilize one and implant it in the mother. They fertilize several and then allow the parents to choose the most viable option for them. The remaining embryos are not distributed amongst other surrogate mothers like, sorry, they didn't want the embryo with birth defects. I guess you got to bring it into this world, because if we flush it down, you know, down the tubes, then that's like taking an adult human life. No, people don't view in vitro fertilization clinics that way. But in order to be consistent, you would have to. And Donald Trump believes that it should be up to the parents to decide. And I concur with that decision, in order to bring life into this world.
Under my leadership, the Republican Party will always support the creation of strong, thriving, and healthy American families. We want to make it easier for mothers and families to have babies, not harder. That includes supporting the availability of fertility treatments like IVF in every state in America. Like the overwhelming majority of Americans, including the vast majority of Republicans, conservatives, Christians, and pro-life Americans, I strongly support the availability of IVF for couples who are trying to have a precious baby. What could be more beautiful or better than that? Today, I'm pleased that the Alabama legislature has acted very quickly and passed legislation that preserves the availability of IVF in Alabama. They really did a great and fast job. The Republican Party should always be on the side of the miracle of life and the side of mothers, father, their beautiful babies, and that's what we are.
I think anything which empowers parents to have the personal agency to make their own decisions on reproduction is ultimately the most beneficial course for all Americans, whether that's pro-life or pro-abortion. And Trump also made, in the course of commenting on the issue of abortion, an interesting drop when it came to how religion interacts with that topic. And we'll play the second part of his release on Truth Social.
Many people have asked me what my position is on abortion and abortion rights, especially since I was proudly the person responsible for the ending of something that all legal scholars, both sides, wanted and, in fact, demanded be ended. Roe v. Wade. They wanted it ended. It must be remembered that the Democrats are the radical ones on this position because they support abortion up to and even beyond the ninth month. My view is now that we have abortion where everybody wanted it from a legal standpoint, The states will determine by vote or legislation or perhaps both. And whatever they decide must be the law of the land. In this case, the law of the state. Many states will be different. Many will have a different number of weeks, or some will have more conservative than others, and that's what they will be. At the end of the day, this is all about the will of the people. You must follow your heart, or in many cases, your religion or your faith.
I don't think so.
Okay, so a couple of things that I'd like to address in that clip. First of all, I'm not sure there was this unanimity of consensus amongst legal scholars that Roe versus Wade must be overturned. Now, certainly it was considered by many to be a very poor ruling from the Supreme Court and not within the purview of federal authority. Granted, but I wouldn't say it was a unanimous consensus amongst all legal representatives, but whatever the case may be, yes, it has now been punted back to the states. But Donald Trump also said that it's important for you to follow your heart or your religion. Yes, you follow your religion. Don't make other people follow your religion. Like if you were on a diet, if I were on a diet, that doesn't mean other people can't have donuts. No, those are rules and restrictions for me. And if you don't wish to pursue an abortion, then by all means, don't. I would certainly also be screaming from the hilltops if abortions were mandatory. Like, no, you have to have an abortion. No, that's taking away freedom from individuals, I feel, is ultimately abhorrent. And it's interesting that in the fallout of overturning Roe versus Wade, we have now slow walked ourselves back to a state where it's most of the states have instituted some access to abortion rights, which is where we were already. So one way or another, I think most of the country agrees that to a certain extent, you should have some access to that service. Now, others are portending dire circumstances if Donald Trump were to be reelected. Curiously, though, abortion didn't top their list because that's not the only issue at election. Of course, there's also the incredible immigration crisis, the supply chain crisis, and the continuing inflation crisis and degradation of the economy, all of which been exacerbated under the leadership of Joe Biden. And then some people are even more ridiculous than that, comparing Donald Trump to Hitler and saying that if he's reelected, then he'll march in the Capitol and then shred the Constitution before our eyes. This was the melodramatic musings of Jennifer Lewis, a washed-up actress who was speaking on Sirius XM.
As soon as he takes the oath, he will have generals walk down the steps of the Capitol. He will take a hammer and break the glass where the Constitution is, and he will tear it up in our faces and say, now, I'm the king of the world. You will bow down, bitches. He will punish everybody that didn't vote for him. Let me tell y'all how I know this. I know it because I know what mental illness looks like.
Mental illness is a political identity and always has been.
That mania is unstoppable. See, this motherfucker is Hitler. He didn't come to play.
You serious?
Now, obviously, the Orange Man is a far cry from Hitler, and any such comparison is absurd on its face. But there are a number of issues that are at play, one of them being abortion, and the way that the states handle this could ultimately decide the outcome of the election. We also saw Arizona Supreme Court making a ruling this week upholding an 1864 law, which would outlaw almost all abortions within the state. Now, Republicans in the legislature are blocking Democrats attempts, and even other Republicans in the party, attempts to overturn that law. Now, when it comes down to how the electoral college votes are distributed, those states matter. Arizona is a battleground state, and that could sway the election 4 points, 5 points more in Joe Biden's favor. When the races are tight, those votes matter. And yes, there are other issues at play, one of them being immigration, one of them being the economy. And here was a deranged TikTok user who was attempting to smear Donald Trump, but in the process accidentally made a pretty banging campaign ad for him.
Wonder what Trump will actually do if he gets back into office? You don't have to speculate, because he calls his plan Agenda 47. And spoiler alert, it's scary as shit. Here are some of the worst ideas we're in store for if he wins in November. 1. Attacking immigration. Trump's anti-immigration policies will be even worse the second time around. He's promised to end birthright citizenship, enlist an army to round up and deport millions of undocumented immigrants, and deploy thousands of U.S. troops to the southern border. 2. Criminalizing LGBTQIA plus Americans. Trump says he'll ban gender-affirming care for trans kids and prevent schools from helping kids through their transition. He wants to forbid schools from even teaching anything about sex and gender that diverges from the far right's idea of the nuclear family. 3. Overhauling education. Agenda 47 includes huge changes to the education system. He wants to give huge benefits for homeschooling to indoctrinate kids with Christian nationalism, incentivize teachers to carry guns in their classrooms, further crack down on affirmative action, and destroy crucial DEI departments at college.
Oh, man.
Think she understood how many people support those policy proposals, like resolving the immigration crisis, preventing children from mutilating themselves, or teachers from indoctrinating people in kindergarten with their gender politics, and eliminating DEI. All of those sounds great to me. So, yeah, there are lots of issues at play in this election. And I'll also point out that in her list, which exceeded beyond those 3 points, abortion didn't come up. So, you know, in two years ago, Democrats were saying that was going to be the premier issue, but things have decayed so rapidly that that's no longer the case. But either way, it's going to come down. I don't think this is going to be a landslide for Republicans, and Republicans better not get cocky like they did in the midterms, because they predicted, it's going to be a big Republican red wave, and it didn't happen. And they better not take for granted people's dissatisfaction with the Biden administration and then lose the presidential election in 2024. Something to think about. Coming up next is the Sound Dump. Don't miss it.
Hammer and Nigel.
Biden constantly lies.
He was doing a victory lap on prices. He said costs were down. Just because it's not at the record level that you were responsible for previously, you don't get to do a victory lap. It's still substantially higher than when your predecessor was in office.
Yeah, and they're not coming back now.
Hammer and Nigel, weekdays 3 till 7 on 93 WIPC and WIPC.com.
I'm John Morgan of Morgan & Morgan. Last year, over 3 million people called Morgan & Morgan in their time of need. And with over 1 million of those calls coming from previous clients, friends, and family.
My name is Jason Williams. It was a rainy day, and I'd gotten hit from behind by a lady that was doing somewhere over 100 miles an hour is what they were saying. I've never dealt with anything like this before. Everybody that I talked to kept saying the same name, which was Morgan & Morgan. I was on hold for maybe 15 seconds. When they come back and said, Jason, we will absolutely take your case. As a non-tech-savvy guy, any question that I had, if I called, text, or emailed, they got right back to me. They made it as easy for me as it could have been.
Thank you for trusting us. We've become the largest injury firm in the world because we've won a lot. The word is out. Size matters. Reputation matters. We're America's largest injury law firm for a reason. With over 900 dedicated attorneys and climbing, we're ready wherever you are, whatever you need. The choice is easy. We're just a phone call away. Injured? Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
Indiana Pathways for Aging helps Hoosier Medicaid members age 60 and over get support at no additional cost to live life their way.
Mom's Parkinson's is progressing, and Pathways provides in-home support so she can be with family every day.
Pathways coordinates Medicaid and Medicare services. I'm getting help with meals, personal care, and transportation.
One day, I might choose a nursing home, but today, I have options with Pathways.
Eligible members can select a plan now. Call 87-PATHWAY-4 or visit in.gov/pathways.
My house has a new glow. I love my windows. Universal Windows Direct.
Hey, it's Rob. Right now, schedule your free in-home estimate, and for every two windows you buy, get the next two free, plus free upgrade to triple pane glass, and they'll double your energy tax credit. Restrictions apply. Like me, you'll be saying, I love my windows.
I love my windows. They've got that brand new home effect. Universal Windows Direct.
News, I'm Roger Stern. Dozens of Iranian drones are on their way to Israel in what appears to be a retaliatory attack for Israel's killing of Iranian generals in Syria.
It will take these drones hours to get here,
and this could be just the initial phase of the Iranian attack against Israel.
Fox's Trey Yinks in Tel Aviv. Israel says it's ready. President Biden has been meeting with his national security team. A man armed with a knife killed six people in a busy shopping mall in Sydney, Australia. Prime Minister Anthony Albanese.
Bondi Junction was the scene of shocking violence, but it was also witness to the humanity and the heroism of our fellow Australians.
Police are ruling out terrorism. America is listening to Fox News.
Hey, Mom.
Hi, honey.
Mom, I'm glad you figured out the video call. What's all that noise? Is it your connection?
No, just doing a few things to the house. Your room will soon be a fitness studio.
My room? What? Well, what's that noise? Is that your Wi-Fi?
Oh, that. Your father's taken up the electric guitar. We're remodeling the basement for his jam sessions.
Jam sessions? Mom, are you guys okay? That's a lot of changes.
I'm just making some upgrades. And it's the home equity line of credit from Lake City Bank. The low fixed rate is helping us get things checked off our list. Oh, honey, gotta go. The hot tub is here.
The what? Mom?
Use Lake City Bank's home equity line of credit for anything from remodels to guitar lessons. Learn more at lakecitybank.com. Call 888-522-2265 or visit a branch near you. Subject to credit approval and equal housing lender.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
Do you need air conditioning service and need to find a local well-trained expert you can trust, like Family Heating and Air Conditioning? Find that American Standard Air dealer at IndyHomeComfort.com.
One in six seniors faces the threat of hunger, and millions more live in isolation. Drop off a hot meal and say a quick hello. Volunteer for Meals on Wheels by donating your lunch break at AmericaLet'sDoLunch.org. This message brought to you by Meals on Wheels America and the Ad Council.
Indy Humane. Find your new best friend today. Visit IndyHumane.org.
But you tell me over and over and over again, my friend, you don't believe we're on the eve of destruction.
You're listening to Saturday Night on The Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back for another stroll through the refuse of a decaying civilization. Democrats are quaking in their boots as what Donald Trump managed to accomplish alone more than doubled what it took three presidents collectively to achieve. Joe Biden continues to decline in popularity as his regular acts of dishonesty and decrepitude in equal measure are put on full display. And in this segment, we'll also ask, how far would you push a dispute over guacamole? All for this edition of The Sound Dump.
I'll take you for a ride. I'm a garbage truck.
It's the Saturday Night Sound Dump on 93 WIPC.
I take you to the dump. I show you the sights, you know you wanna ride. I'm a garbage truck.
Welcome back to Saturday Night on The Circle. I'm your host, Ethan Hatcher, producer Corbin, beep, 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 pushing the buttons and doing everything to make the show function. We're beginning with Donald Trump taking a bit of a victory lap for his enormous fundraising success. Last Saturday, he held a dinner while this show was going on, in which he collectively raked in more than $50 million, which was more than double the $25 million that it took Joe Biden, Bill Clinton, and Barack Obama to raise at the Radio City Music Hall a couple weeks ago, the same day that Jonathan Diller's wake was being held in New York. But here was Trump's enormous fundraising success, as reported by Fox News.
Trump is calling it the biggest night in fundraising history. The fundraiser at hedge fund billionaire John Paulson's home raked in over $50 million, according to the RNC. That's up from early estimates of $43 million, and nearly double what President Biden raised at his New York City fundraiser with former Presidents Obama and Clinton. This was the first major fundraiser for Trump and the RNC since he became the party's presumptive presidential nominee. Trump said his supporters are contributing to a cause that will restore faith in our country.
People are just wanting change. The rich people want it. Poor people want it. Everybody wants change. The country is really doing poorly. We're a laughing stock all over the world, and we're going to get that change very quickly.
Oh, my God! Okay, it's happening. Everybody stay calm.
What's the procedure, everyone? What's the procedure?
Stay calm!
In some ways, the Democrats did Donald Trump an enormous favor by going through with that fundraiser at Radio City Music Hall the same day that Troop Jonathan Diller's wake was being held, because it set up a fantastic comparison between the two parties, whereas you had Donald Trump sympathizing with the family, doing what he could to support them and empathize with them, and also contributed enough to the widow and donated to pay off her mortgage, which was an enormous relief to the family as well. Whereas, you know, Donald Trump spent that day in service to others. Joe Biden spent it in service to himself at this glitzy shindig with Bill Clinton, Barack Obama, and of course, Stephen Colbert, host of The Late Show on NBC. So I think people can also see on a regular basis Joe Biden's blatant dishonesty in many cases as he disingenuously attempts to connect with the middle class that he shares no connection with. And he lies about it enough that we have a pretty compelling montage.
People say to me, it's great you're helping people into college. How about all those hardworking people who grew up and had no opportunity to go to college? I get it. That's the neighborhood I come from. That's why a big part of my economic agenda is investing in all Americans, whether you attend college or not.
Liar! Liar! Liar!
Get back, witch!
So he's trying to act like he wasn't born with a silver spoon in his mouth. And, you know, he connects with the middle class background. But it starts to fall apart when you realize he's also claimed to be raised in the Puerto Rican, Greek, Irish, Catholic, Jewish, Italian, Polish, Palestinian, Persian, and Black communities of Delaware, an impossibility that is hilarious to watch unfold his dishonesty.
I was sort of raised in the Puerto Rican community. I had a very close relationship with the Greek American community, for real.
I am Joe Bidenopoulos.
I grew up in a heavily Irish Catholic community in Scranton, Pennsylvania, and a heavily Italian Polish community.
When I say I got raised in the Black church, he knows I'm not kidding.
The Persian culture is amazing as a student of Persian culture.
I probably went to shul more than many of you.
I come out of the Black community. The background of my family is Irish American, not fundamentally unlike the Palestinian people.
I raised in the synagogue in my state.
Everybody in town was either Polish or Italian. I grew up feeling self-conscious. My name didn't end in an SKI.
I was raised in a neighborhood where I felt self-conscious. My name didn't end in O.
That's kind of how I was raised, like so many Americans of Irish heritage.
In HBCU, in your home state, Mr. President. Let me tell you, forget about it. That's where I got raised, man.
Just like rabbis, synagogues, and Jewish community centers in your hometown, and that's the tradition I got raised.
Old man can't keep his story straight. That is absolutely shameless, and I could have extended it from there, but he's so transparently, you know, trying to be relatable, but in the process is so dishonest that it pushes any reasonable people away, and I think that's part of the explanatory factor that explains Donald Trump's fundraising success in comparison. Now, he's got to play catch-up, because Joe Biden has a head start and a large war chest right now. But if he keeps the fundraising efforts up like he did last week, then he is certainly well on his way. It's not just the dishonesty from Joe Biden that's factoring into his unpopularity. It's also the decrepitude, which is repeatedly put on parade. This week, he seemed to think it was still the 1970s and that he was going to resolve the war in Vietnam.
Did you spend a lot of time thinking about what your legacy would look like?
Well, I hope the legacy is that I kept my word, that I said that the reason I was running was to help change the life of ordinary people and reduce the prospect of war. And because of Vietnam. And when I ran, I said that I was once asked, well, why wouldn't, when I was 1 and 29 years old, I said, it must be a secret. And I said, yeah, the secret you got to ask yourself is, what are you willing to lose over? You figure out what you're willing to lose over, you got an idea of what you should be doing. And so I hope my legacy is that I was honest, straightforward, and did what I said.
You sit on a throne of lies.
Well, at least if he's setting out to end the conflict in Vietnam, that can be one achievement Joe Biden can chalk up to his administration, because that's one thing that at least that problem has long since been solved. Now, he didn't do it, but if he believes he did, you know, let the old man give himself a gold star, I guess. It's just he doesn't know what year it is. He doesn't know what's going on. He can't read the teleprompter, can't follow along with his note cards, can't do a press conference. It's been more than 100 days since the last press conference. The State of the Union, he was shouting at the crowd, and it looked like he was wired up. Man's fallen apart at the seams, but he's not the only one. This was a Colorado representative who was really upset. This is Brianna Titone, who was triggered after Republican Ken DeGraff called her a sir. She didn't like that.
Representative DeGraff. Thank you, Mr. Chair. I'd like to... It's Madam Chair. Thank you.
Excuse me, it's ma'am. It is ma'am.
Thank you. I'd like to move J067 to House Bill 1430 and ask that it be properly displayed.
Little weird. Slightly crazy.
I'm on my land. We're both in America, which used to be a good country until they started letting people like you do whatever you want.
It's understandable why he would make that mistake, considering that Brianna is the first transgender individual to hold the position of speaker in the Colorado legislature. One final thing before we go to the next break. Of course, there was conflict in southern Michigan, a dispute over guacamole at the Chipotle.
You know, we've been covering the news for a long time, but this is a first. A shooting over a guacamole at a crowded restaurant with tons of people eating and in line. It's hard to believe, but we talked to witnesses who saw it all firsthand. Take a look.
Chaos at Chipotle. A customer shoots an employee.
It was loud, and then we all just ran out because it was... Yeah, I mean, wouldn't expect to, I wasn't really thinking about there was going to be a shot, but there was.
It happened shortly before 7 o'clock Friday night at the Chipotle on Evergreen in Southfield. Witnesses say it all started out as an argument over food. The source close to the investigation says it was specifically over guacamole.
It's a lucky thing I had my pieces.
Your pieces?
My guns.
Oh.
Anyway, I started blasting. Bam, wow. Bam.
Now, I like Chipotle as much as the next guy, but I don't care. No guacamole is worth a prison sentence. But, you know, I guess they feel differently in Michigan. Must be really good Chipotle up there. Might be worth a trip. Thanks for listening to Saturday Night on The Circle. Coming up next, I didn't have Tucker Carlson opening for a Kid Rock concert on my 2024 bingo card, but we live in such insane times. That's where we are. I'll play you excerpts from his opening act coming up next. Stay tuned.
You let him try violin because you love him.
And if you love him that much, love him enough to make sure he's buckled up and in the back seat. Find out more at nhtsa.gov/the right seat. Brought to you by the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration and the Ad Council.
Hey, it's Hammer and Nigel for Window Nation. Now, you may hear the same offers from competing window companies. So why would you choose Window Nation over the rest? Window Nation is all about paying attention to detail. They measure their windows 3 times to ensure the proper fit. They have a 96% customer satisfaction rating, so they get the job done right the first time. They are experienced. Each installer has averaged over 10 years of experience.
You could have the best window in the world, but if it's not installed properly, it's not going to do you any good. Window Nation, they use top-of-the-line materials to ensure that your windows are installed perfectly the first time, and they back everything with a lifetime warranty. To go along with all these reasons, there's also this amazing deal. Buy 2 windows, get 2 for free. And there's no limit. 0 interest or payments for 24 months. You can't afford to miss this deal. Go with the experts. Go with Window Nation. 866-90-NATION or visit windownation.com to schedule your free in-home estimate.
It's the first day of the first grade, and she found a new best friend. It's a laid-back Sunday afternoon you wish would never end.
The homemade taste of Bluebell and good friends gathered round. The good old days are being made right now.
St. Louis brought the world gooey butter cake. Now Bluebell brings us gooey butter cake ice cream. A cake batter ice cream with a luscious cream cheese swirl and gooey butter cake pieces. Mmm, it's the gateway to the best in pints and half gallons.
The good old days are being made right now.
The good old days are being made right now.
Look for Bluebell ice cream at all Meijer stores.
Let Bill Estes put you behind the wheel of the powerhouse brands that define American toughness. Ford, Chevy, Ram, and GMC.
Get 2.9% APR for 72 months on all GMC Sierra 1500s, plus $2,000 customer cash on 6.2-liter Sierra Denalis.
Unleash the power of the road with Bill Estes Trucks. Find the location near you and see their inventory at BillEstesTrucks.com.
Financing for well-qualified buyers. Some customers may not qualify. Not available with lease and some other offers. See dealer for details.
You want to listen all day to WIPC, but you don't always have time. Don't worry, there's a podcast for that. The WIPC Mashup. Daily highlights from your favorite hosts, Tony Katz, Kendall and Casey, and Hammer and Nigel. Subscribe wherever you get your podcasts.
This is Saturday Night on The Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back to Saturday Night on The Circle. This week, quite unexpectedly, Tucker Carlson was the opening act for a Kid Rock concert. And for what it's worth, the crowd appeared to receive him quite well. But Tucker was riding high, not just on the energy. I think something else may have been wafting through the air.
I feel welcome, thank you. You may be asking, what am I doing here? And you know, I don't really know. Thank you. So, I wound up here tonight because I was having dinner at my house with Kid Rock.
Like you do.
And a few months ago, and he said, and I think he likes my house because you can smoke in my house. but he said, you know, you should come and open for me on my summer tour. And I said, well, I'm honored, of course, but I don't play an instrument. Actually, I'm an unemployed talk show host, so what would I do at your show? And he said, and I'm quoting now, you will figure it out and you will like it.
Now, given the manic laughter on display, I don't think that they were just smoking at the house. I think they may have been smoking a little bit behind the backstage before the concert got started. But that's okay. Everybody needs to relax. Tucker Carlson also made an interesting, it was an interesting twist when he seemingly threw his wife and dogs under the bus because he feels more connection with strangers in Louisiana than he does with his partner and his pets.
I woke up this morning, and maybe you have this experience. I woke up this morning and I went on the internet. Familiar? And I read all these stories and I thought to myself, this is the most depressing thing that's happened to me in a long time. This country is f***ing up. That's what I thought. I did think that. Which is a sad thing to think when you're in bed. And I looked over at my wife and my four dogs and I thought, woo, I feel a little depressed. And then I got here and I walked through the crowd and I thought, no. No, it's not. The country they tell me about on the internet is f***ed up. The country that I experience when I walk through this crowd or when I wake up in my town of 100 people in a rural area is a beautiful country.
I hope his wife didn't hear that. I mean, and what the dogs do. I understand not every marriage is happy, but the pets, surely, they put a smile on your face, but not Tucker Carlson, I guess. Now, before we end the segment, I wanted to play the supercut of Tucker Carlson being lost in the giggle weeds. I think he was definitely feeling a contact high from the crowd.
Thank you. Your show.
Tucker was certainly enjoying himself, and you know, the crowd seemed to respond well for what it was worth. Thanks for listening to Saturday Night on the Circle. Stay tuned in hour two. Friend of the show, Rob Kendall, is joining the program.
Now if you're heading on home or you're taking a getaway, well, there's so much to see at the crossroads of the USA.
No matter where you're headed, it's nice to know Hubler's got you covered for 100,000 miles. Plus, every Hubler Q-certified vehicle is covered by a 128-point vehicle inspection and a free Carfax history report. Shop any of Hubler's 12 locations and choose from over 2,000 vehicles. Chevys, Fords, GMCs, Buicks, Nissans, Acuras, Mazdas, Hondas, and many more. All makes, all models, certified vehicles, luxury vehicles, even the hard-to-find ones.
'Cause Hubler, Hubler's got you covered.
No matter where you're headed, it's nice to know Hubler's got you covered. So what drives Indiana? DriveHubler.com.
Cover me!
Warranty on select models less than 9 years old.
QC Kinetics announces the arrival of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, an acclaimed orthopedic surgeon with two decades of experience and extensive research in regenerative medicine.
But I was one of the first orthopedic surgeons to do it, and at the same time, I integrated clinical research that's resulted in several publications that are really directing the future of regenerative medicine. I was drawn to QC Kinetics after I reviewed their protocols, and everything they were doing is consistent with my own approach.
Today, Dr. Scheinkup leads the entire team of medical professionals at QC Kinetics, taking this exciting medical breakthrough to a whole new level.
What we are doing at QC Kinetics is transforming lives.
Get lasting joint pain relief. Call QC Kinetics now for your free consultation.
This is the future of medicine.
Call QC Kinetics, 317-559-PAIN. That's 317-559-PAIN. At Eagle Creek, Greenwood, and Carmel, 317-559-PAIN.
Denny Smith here for Sundown Gardens in Westfield. The tropicals are here for you and ready to sell, and the nursery is so well stocked in Westfield and certainly ready for you to shop. Sundown Gardens is ready to beautify your garden and yard this spring. Enjoy the spring weather and plan a trip to Sundown Gardens at 186th Street and Spring Mill Road in Westfield. Flowers, trees, shrubs, mulch, and more. Sundown Gardens in Westfield has it. 186th Street and Spring Mill Road, just west of Grand Park. Follow them on social media for daily updates at sundowngardens.com.
Hey, y'all, I'm Blake Shelton. Being from Oklahoma, I know a thing or two about natural disasters. Tornadoes are common where I'm from and have affected my life and the lives of people I care about. No matter where you live, be aware of the dangers in your area and have a plan. You can create an emergency kit, come up with an evacuation plan, and know where to seek shelter. You never know when a disaster may hit. These simple steps can help save a life. This message is brought to you by the U.S. Air Force.
Broadcasting from the Technology Recycler Studios, this is Indy's Mobile News, 93 WIBC, WIBC HD1 Indianapolis. The news starts now.
Drones heading to Israel. I'm Roger Stern, Fox News. President Biden cutting short his weekend in Delaware as Iran launches attacks against Israel. Fox's Jared Halpern with more from Washington.
The president returned from his home in Rehoboth Beach, Delaware, to meet with his national security team in the White House Situation Room. President Biden has been clear. A statement from the National Security Council says that U.S. support for Israel's security is ironclad, and the administration stands with the people of Israel and support their defense against Iranian threats. Defense Secretary Lloyd Austin has spoken with his Israeli counterpart by phone, saying Israel can count on full U.S. support to defend Israel against any attacks by Iran and its regional proxies. In Washington, Jared Halpern, Fox News.
The U.S., Jordan, and the U.K. managing to take down some of the drones. Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu said today, Israel's air defenses are deployed. We are ready for any scenario, both in attack and in defense. A man fatally stabbed six people at a mall in Sydney, Australia today, then was shot to death by police. Australian Prime Minister Anthony Albanese praising police, first responders, and citizens responding during the attack.
Bondi Junction was the scene of shocking violence, but it was also witness to the humanity and the heroism of our fellow Australians. Our brave police, our first responders, and of course everyday people who could never have imagined that they would face such a moment.
Witnesses say the suspect appeared to attack people at random. Police at this stage do not believe the attack was terror-related, and the mall will remain closed while an investigation continues. America is listening to Fox News.
Stay on top of the latest forecast with America's Weather Team in the palm of your hands.
Here's the latest from America's Weather Center.
It's Fox Weather updates throughout your busy day, every day.
That heat's going to be out there for one more day.
Temperatures being 30 degrees above average.
Put the power of over 100 meteorologists and the worldwide resources of Fox in your hands with the Fox Weather Podcast. Precise, personal, powerful. Subscribe and listen now at foxnewspodcasts.com.
Connect to Fox News Audio on the Fox News app. Listen to hear your favorite hosts like Brian Kilmeade, Jimmy Failla, and Guy Benson standing up for what's right live and via podcast. Just click listen, then swipe right and hear the latest news updates on your time. And scroll down to hear the latest podcasts from Fox News. And it's even easier to listen in the car with Apple CarPlay and Android Auto. Get programming alerts and notifications. Fox News Audio is on the Fox News app, the voices America trusts. Download it now.
93 WIBC Mobile News, on the level, on the go.
Number 12 was back in town. I'm Wes Woodward, and here's what's trending this hour. Former Colts quarterback Andrew Luck and former Colts head coach Chuck Pagano helped raise $1 million for cancer research Friday. Team owner Jim Irsay promised to donate that amount if the two could toss footballs to knock down 16 boards in 60 seconds. That's the sound of attendees celebrating in a video posted to Twitter by Wish TV's Anthony Calhoun. A simple food delivery gone wrong, Harrison Silcox reports.
When you spend $30 on an Uber meal, you don't expect to spend $2,600 to fix a garage.
Brock Hardesty, who lives in Plainfield, tells Wish TV he ordered food for him and his dad through Uber Eats when they heard a loud bang.
I go back around to the front door. My food's sitting there, which was great, but the driver's gone. The car's gone.
Hardesty says he's been communicating with Uber to see what can be done. If anything, the garage repairs could cost him over $2,000. Harrison Silcox, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
The staff at Ascension St. Vincent in Fishers has been delivering babies since 2013.
and a baby they delivered this week is very special to them. I'm John Herrick. Neela Kripe was born this Wednesday to Daphne Sanchez and Trevor Kripe. It is the 5,000th baby delivered at Ascension St. Vincent over the last 11 years. Dr. Valerie Gathers works at Ascension.
It's so exciting. I'm a Fishers resident, so this is even exciting for me because I'm getting to deliver my neighbors, friends. It's awesome.
John Herrick, 93 WIBC Mobile News.
On the level, on the go, and on WIBC.com. Now here's the forecast in the American Standard Cooling Weather Center.
Tonight, clouds increase to partly cloudy, low temperatures in the mid-50s. Sunday, there may be an isolated shower or storm, primarily in eastern Indiana. High temperatures in the mid to upper 70s. I'm Wish TV Storm Track 8 meteorologist Ryan Morse for 93 WIBC.
Are you struggling with anxiety, depression, and other mental health issues, but feel like you have to keep it together to tell everyone, I'm fine? Hi, this is Pastor Micah Beckwith from Life Church, and we want you to know you're not alone. Starting April 7th, we're launching a new five-week series called I'm Not Fine to bring awareness and understanding to mental illness. Through powerful stories, biblical teaching, and community support, we'll explore what it means to honestly face our struggles and find healing. Join us this Sunday as we kick off I'm Not Fine and start breaking down the stigmas together. Go to lifechurchin.com for our service times and locations. It's not about being fine. It's about finding life. We'll see you this weekend.
Did you know one of the best investments you can make? It's in yourself. At My Computer Career, in just a few months, you could start your new career in the high-demand, recession-resistant field of information technology. Isn't it time you invest in you and start a career in networking, cybersecurity, AI, or upskill to boost your current IT career? So, get the ROI you deserve at My Computer Career. No experience necessary. Start now at mycomputercareer.edu.
Financial aid is available for qualified students, including the GI Bill.
Uh-oh, Brad's buzzed.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah, he's starting with the woots. Good thing is, he knows when he's buzzed.
Know your buzzed warning signs? Call for a ride when it's time to go home. Buzz driving is drunk driving. A message from NHTSA and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Saturday Night on the Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Stay tuned because in the next segment, friend of the program, Rob Kendall, is joining the show. And we're going to talk about the judge in Southern Indiana slapping down Jamie Noel with a contempt of court charge, sentencing him to 60 days in jail. And my own socialist city council member, Jesse Brown, has released a statement following his hit and run collision that he was a victim of when his bicycle was collided with last week. So stay tuned for that. But in the first segment, I want to celebrate a little bit because a renowned scumbag has finally left the earth.
Let the joyous news be spread. The wicked old witch at last is dead.
Now, usually I don't celebrate the demise of another human being, but I think we can make an exception for a shameless murderer that was given a pass. And now, and of course I'm referring to O.J. Simpson, who this week passed away from cancer, getting the death in old age that Nicole Brown and Ron Goldman should have received, but instead he got that the privilege that they did not, passing away peacefully from cancer. A bit of a surprise. I don't think the family had publicly shared his cancer diagnosis, but finally he has left the face of this earth, and now the racists are really coming out in force in showing their support of OJ. This was a contributor on CNN who was saying that they rejoiced in his acquittal from a murder charge because OJ killed two white people.
It was so racially charged because of what had happened just before with Rodney King, but also just how Black Americans feel about policing. It's not like O.J. Simpson was the leader of the civil rights movement of his era. You know, he wasn't a social justice leader, but he represented something for the Black community in that moment, in that trial, particularly because there were two white people who had been killed. Ooh. And the history around how Black people have been persecuted during slavery. There were just so many layers. And I guess I would just close with this, is that there was racial tension then, there is racial tension now. It might not be the backdrop of the Trump campaign, but until this country is ready to actually have an honest conversation about the racial dynamics from our origin story till today, we will always have moments like O.J. Simpson that manifest.
That's racist!
Well, they're going to acquit more murderers as restitution for police brutality? What kind of sick racist mentality is that? And celebrating the fact that OJ killed two white people, thus making him an icon of the Black Lives Matter civil rights movement? What is this? This is abhorrent, but allowed to be said out loud and with a straight face. And now we are finding out and documenting that, yes, they understood OJ was guilty and they just acquitted him anyway, again, as retribution for police brutality and the Rodney King riots and the beating that he had taken in the early 90s. This was a juror on the OJ Simpson trial admitting they knew that he was guilty. They acquitted him anyway.
Do you think that they're members of the jury that voted to acquit OJ because of Rodney King?
Yes.
You do?
Yes.
How many of you think felt that way?
Oh, probably 90% of us.
90%? Did you feel that way?
Yes.
That was payback.
Uh-huh.
Holy Jesus. What is that? What the f*** is that?
Payback. Payback. And in the process, letting a murderer run off scot-free and then die in old age in comfort surrounded by his family, something that he denied to other human beings. That's breathtaking and absolutely disgusting. And another CNN contributor, Stephanie Elam, almost said the quiet part out loud. Again, people were rejoicing because in the racist calculus, a black man was acquitted for the murder of white people, and that was a reversal of the ordinary scenario, and that makes it justified in their minds. This was the musing of Stephanie Elam.
It's also just worth noting how much was impacted by this trial, Jake. So many things happened. We saw policing changing here in the city. And it's also worth noting, because of that unrest, that racial unrest in the 90s, that is why so many people who may not have been invested in O.J. Simpson were just happy to see that someone who was rich and famous and black could get away with what other people did in the system as well, too.
You can't keep getting away with it! He can't keep getting away with it.
She almost said it. She almost said it. Gotten away with so many other people have gotten away with in the system. They're rejoicing because a black man got away with murder, which is just the most wildly racist thing I think you could come up with. Now, you won't see any sympathy here for the passing of O.J. Simpson because, I mean, obviously he was a murderer who got away with it, and that doesn't deserve any sympathy. It's just a shame that famed comedian Norm Macdonald passed away, and he couldn't live to see this moment and make some jokes because they would have been fantastic. Of course, that's why he lost his job on Saturday Night Live doing the Weekend Update, because he wouldn't stop needling this issue time and time again. And I can only imagine what he'd say now in that classic dry wit of his. Cancer did what the state of California could never accomplish. Executing O.J. Simpson. And the crowd would laugh and it would go on from there. In celebration of his passing and commemoration of Norm Macdonald, here is a supercut of some of his finest jokes from the Weekend Update.
According to retailers, the most popular Halloween mask this year is O.J. Simpson. And the most popular Halloween greeting is, I'll kill you and that guy who's bringing over your glasses, or treat. And the Pope came out with a book this week, which contains a series of essays examining faith and morality in today's secular world and the changing role of the Catholic Church as it approaches the 21st century. The book is entitled, God Himself Told Me That O.J. Is Guilty. In his book, O.J. Simpson says that he would have taken a bullet or stood in front of a train for Nicole. Man, I'm going to tell you, that is some bad luck when the one guy who would have died for you kills you. That's probably... You don't get worse luck than that. Testimony during the final week provided some spellbinding moments. In a brilliant move during closing arguments, Simpson attorney Johnny Cochran put on the knit cap prosecutors say O.J. wore the night he committed the murders. Although O.J. may have hurt his case when he suddenly blurted out, hey, easy with that. That's my lucky stabbing hat.
That's my lucky stabbing hat. Man, they don't make sardonic wits like Norm Macdonald anymore. He was one of a kind, and it's just a pity he couldn't have lived to see this moment. Thanks for listening to Saturday Night on The Circle. If you missed a moment of the program, catch my podcasts uploaded to WIBC.com and SaturdayNightOnTheCircle.fireside.fm. Coming up in the next segment, friend of the show, Rob Kendall joins the program, and together we're going to discuss the latest update to the unfolding saga of Jamie Noel, former sheriff of Clark County, and of course, my socialist city council member has released a statement following being the victim of a hit-and-run accident on his bike last week. We'll tell you about it up next.
Like magic, it appears in the sky. A rainbow. Somewhere over that rainbow lurks not bluebirds or dreams. Hidden behind that beauty is trouble.
Get a cone tornado over there.
Don't be fooled.
Tornado on the ground! Confirm tornado on the ground!
Confirmed tornadoes.
Oh my gosh, look at it. Oh my God.
This spring, depend on your severe weather station.
Baseball size hail.
93 WIBC.
I've been asked 1,000 times, did you plan on becoming the largest injury law firm in the world? And the answer is no. When I started, there were just two of us. Today, Morgan & Morgan has almost 800 lawyers alone. No injury firm in the country has anywhere close to that. We set out to be focused on our clients and to have a commitment to trying cases and winning. And when you have those results at trial, you're able to settle most of your cases quickly and fairly. Reputation matters. We grew like this because we worked hard and so many former clients referred family and friends. And what I believe is the main reason is we delivered for our clients a lot. Hard work and client satisfaction was our plan. It worked. Hope is not a plan. Morgan & Morgan, America's largest injury law firm. Visit forthepeople.com for an office near you.
Sinus pressure, congestion, snoring, being unable to sleep, being unable to breathe. Yep, it's another sinus infection. You've Googled, watched videos, tried over-the-counter sprays, medications, and home remedies, but nothing ever works. There must be some kind of treatment that can help, right? Indianapolis Sinus Center understands how draining it can be when you try treatment after treatment without any relief. That's why they've been serving and treating the community for over 50 years. Indianapolis Sinus Center has performed thousands of procedures and helped thousands of patients find lasting relief they didn't know was possible. Patients like you. If you've had enough of sinus pain, pressure, and congestion, schedule a visit with Indianapolis Sinus Center today. Call 317-528-9650 and take the first step toward breathing easy. 317-528-9650. That's 317-528-9650 or visit IndianapolisSinusCenter.com.
Diamonds Direct Spring Sale is here. Shop now and get an extra 20% off Diamonds Direct's renowned prices. It's the best sale of the season. Plus, book an appointment and get an additional $100 off. That's 20% off plus $100 off store-wide. Rings, earrings, pendants, bracelets, engagement rings, and more. And enjoy an expanded selection with designer appearances each weekend. 20% off now to April 21st and open Sundays. Details at DiamondsDirect.com.
Tune in to the Absolute Retirement Planning Show.
When retirement comes about, we're now relying on what we have saved to meet those needs.
Sundays at 9 a.m. right here on 93 WIBC.
To protect his family from disaster, Steve used his camera phone.
Done.
By taking pictures of his important documents, Steve can always have them stored online. Learn more simple disaster prep tips at ready.gov. A message from FEMA and the Ad Council.
We need each other because every someone needs someone else.
We need each other because when we work together, we can do so much more.
We connect more children with what they need to grow up healthy, educated, and safe. And that's what Child Fund is all about.
Because when you make someone's world better, you make everyone's world better.
Child Fund, because we need each other.
Learn more at childfund.org. That's childfund.org.
Indy's leader in patio installation is now offering a new driveway package. Schedule a free estimate today at IndyDecorativeConcrete.com. That's IndyDecorativeConcrete.com.
Through their service, veterans have our backs. Now we should have theirs. Learn more at GotYourSix.org.
You're listening to Saturday Night on the Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back to Saturday Night on the Circle. I'm your Bohemian codger, Ethan Hatcher. Find my podcasts uploaded to WIBC.com and SaturdayNightOnTheCircle.fireside.fm. Plus, always find us streaming live each weekend on the YouTube machine. This week, an enraged judge smacked down former Sheriff Jamie Noel with a contempt of court charge, sentencing him to 60 days in jail for flouting the rule of law. Also, Socialist City Council member Jesse Brown has released a highly melodramatic 8-page statement following the hit-and-run incident last week where he was struck while riding a bicycle. Joining us now to collectively mock misbehaving elected officials is one half of the award-winning Kendall and Casey show, the often-off-the-rails Rob Kendall is with us on the program. Hello, sir.
Ethan, you get skinnier and better looking every time I see you, buddy.
I appreciate it, man. It's taken a lot of work to keep up with the diet, but, you know, the lifestyle change is worth it overall.
Yeah, I can totally see it. You look great.
So, of course, you have been all over the ongoing saga with Jamie Noel that is unfolding in Clark County, and it's something special to witness. He's got more than 25 felony counts already against him, and now he's been smacked with contempt of court and sentenced to 60 days in prison by Judge Medlock, and here was the outrageous moments caught on tape.
I told Mr. Noel, don't do anything stupid. Do not try to deceive me, defy me. You will not like the consequences. Today is that day.
Oh, bitch, get out the way. Get out the way, bitch, get out the way.
You are not the law. You don't interpret the law. You don't enforce the law. You're not above the law. I find that you are in contempt of this court. Take him into custody.
It was beautiful, Rob. It was beautiful. And this is stemming from a warrant that was executed on his property, which discovered two firearms that he wasn't supposed to have.
Yeah, so just real quick, Jamie Noel's a former sheriff of Clark County. He was star of a reality TV show called 60 Days In, which is why the judge probably gave him 60 days. And I think he basically alluded to that in his sentencing, it was a reality TV show where they had regular people kind of were like spies in the Clark County jail that he was the sheriff of. There were hidden cameras that would capture what was going on. But he's probably, from an actual importance to our listener standpoint, he was the Clark County Republican County chairman, and he was a part of the Republican Central Committee for the state of Indiana, which made him one of the 20 most powerful Republicans in the entire state. And he was one of the closest personal friends and political allies of the governor. Now, he is accused, as you said, he's charged with 25 felonies. The feds are looking into him as well. His wife is implicated in this. His daughter is implicated in this. Just all sorts of horrible, horrible things related to his abuse of power as a sheriff. He was, you know, one of the head honchos at this volunteer fire department that he was abusing funds. And so the question now that everybody up here should be asking, and I have no idea why the Indianapolis media outside of us here at WIBC and Abdul, really nobody else is reporting on this. How does the governor, it's indisputable that Holcomb and Noel were thick as thieves, and it goes way, way back. They were personal friends. They were political allies. How does the governor not know that one of his closest personal friends and political allies was allegedly living millions of dollars potentially beyond his means? The trips, he had a child out of wedlock that he was financing. Just all of these things are going on, and not one person is asking the governor, what did you know about this guy and when?
And when did you know it? And it also highlights the vulnerabilities in our election system, given that he was a Republican county chair. He's one of those people that can decide whether or not you're allowed to run as a Republican. And this is an individual with very serious charges in the dozens against him. And this is the person who's deciding whether or not you count as a Republican or are allowed to run.
Well, and there's a lot of people who believe that Jamie Noel was very politically ambitious. Obviously,
sure.
He was. And he
association of the governor.
Well, really. And when we talk about close association of the governor, there are photographs. They were on social media. I think some of them have since been removed, but the internet's forever. That you know, like the governor was even checking in on Jamie Knoll's daughter at college. I mean, that's how close these people were. And there's a lot of people who believe that Jamie Knoll wanted to be the superintendent of the state police, and that was something he was gunning for. And some power brokers in the Republican Party knew for many, many years about all this dirt on Knoll, and he flew too close to the sun, and then the people in charge said, you go squish, and that's why he's in the position he's in now.
In so many ways, think about how shameless this individual is to flout the law while under incredibly close scrutiny and having been forewarned. A part of the clip that we didn't play was the judge talking about how he didn't buy these bull crap excuses from Jamie Knoll. Like, oh, well, you know, how many times in your capacity as a former law enforcement official have you heard suspects say, oh, I didn't know that wasn't my gun, that was my friend's gun. Yeah. And now he's trying to do the same thing. Uh-uh, doesn't fly. Yeah, does not fly.
So what this relates to is, as part of his bail, was Knoll had a little massive amount of firearms, and the judge said, look, I will allow you to have a firearm in your home. A shotgun for personal protection. Everything else has to be turned in. He had guns that were found in a raid that he had not turned in, and the judge is saying, wait a second. You're faced with this colossal amount of evidence against you and these charges against you. I gave you a break by allowing you not to have to stay in jail. And here you are directly defying what I had told you to do. And that's why he's now spending 60 days, I believe it's in the Scott County Jail.
Well, the age-old wisdom is when you're in a hole, stop digging!
Yeah.
I guess he didn't get the memo.
But the issue that everybody should be talking about, and amazes me that no one will pin the governor down on how you didn't know that one of your closest personal friends and political allies was allegedly living millions of dollars beyond his means. How did you not notice any of this nor ask him what in the world is going on here?
It's a very important question, one that will likely be set to the side as Governor Eric Holcomb steps aside from his office and, you know, retires off into the sunset.
It's crazy.
Now, there was another story. I've been following this because it's dealing with my city council member, self-proclaimed socialist Jesse Brown. Either last week or the week before, he was involved in a hit-and-run incident where he was struck while riding his bicycle by a driver, a motorist who wasn't paying attention, and later fled the scene. Now,
real quick. So Brown gets hit by this guy.
Yes.
The guy meets with him. The guy
offers to pay him money on the Cash App.
That's his allegation, right? Yeah. Brown's allegation. And then when Brown says, no, we got to call this into the police, the guy flees the scene, right?
Right.
Is that the synopsis?
That is the basic summary of the course of events. And what makes this so humorous is that Jesse Brown has very prominently campaigned on being a police and prison abolitionist.
Yeah.
But when moment of crisis finally came for Jesse, obviously his rational instinct kicked in and it was time to call the cops. He's now—
Which is correct, right? That's
right.
What you should have done.
Correct. Now he's trying to backpedal out of this thing, and he released an 8-page, very weepy, melodramatic letter explaining the course of it. I just want to read some excerpts from this because it's really golden. Quote from Jesse Brown. I wish I could say I responded with grace and professionalism, but I did not. From the driver's perspective, a tall white man in a red hat stood up and was screaming at him, obviously not thinking clearly.
So the driver was, black.
Yes.
Is that right?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes. Each of us was terrified that the other might be armed and might be wishing the other physical harm. He was obviously extremely young and inexperienced. He was terrified. Still, he managed to immediately and repeatedly apologize. Offended and still enraged, I insisted that we had to call the police for the accident report. But from his perspective, the guy that hit and run, the criminal, from his perspective, this angry white man was screaming at him and talking about summoning the police, as white people have done for decades, and as often results in both criminal record and brutality.
So he
drove away. I screamed after him that he was committing a hit and run. I wrote down the license plate number. I felt victimized, shocked, and I was still in the throes of trauma, as I'm sure he was.
So let me make sure I have this
criminal.
Right. So this Jesse Brown guy is apologizing because some dude hit him.
And he called the cops.
Now, I don't think anybody's alleging it was intentional, but clearly you get hit by somebody while riding a bike, unless you're in the wrong, you're going to be really upset about that. The guy tried to, because maybe he thought an acknowledgement he was in the wrong and this is going to be bad, tried to give him money of some sort, was
tried
the initial
to offer
allegation.
Money on the Cash App. Instead, so that way we don't have to report this to the insurance. We'll settle this here. And Jesse turned him down on that
Which
offer.
All appears to be in the confines of, like, responsible behavior.
Yes.
And, hey, I'd like to get this on record that I was drilled by an automobile, and I'd like to have, you know, a neutral arbiter here of law enforcement jot this all down and decide how we proceed. He's now apologizing because he's so wed to the lunacy that is socialism, and the lunacy that the defund the police, BLM, whatever crowd, which props a guy like this up. He's so wed to that that he is now apologizing because he got law enforcement involved after he got hit by an automobile.
You have that right, Rob. He then spends several paragraphs throwing the police under the bus, talking about since he was just a young teenager with dreadlocks, police have been persecuting him and his friends. And even a police officer, he said, in Iowa, drove across from him on the highway and shot finger guns at him because he had socialist bumper stickers.
Well, and think about this, Ethan. This is, it's easy for us to point at this and go, this man is insane and this is laughable. But he gets to be a decider for you.
Yeah.
He is your rep, right?
Republicans didn't even bother to run an opposition candidate. Yep. I voted for Libertarian Libby Glass. Yeah. Thank God somebody decided it was worth running in the district.
So think about this. This crazy person who is totally wed to a lunatic Marxist ideology is the decider for you, and this is where he's at. Instead of saying, no, this guy hit me. And instead of owning up to it and facing whatever consequence, again, I don't think anybody thinks he was trying to hit him, but clearly there's responsibility as a motorist, and you have to let law enforcement kind of sort through that and determine, you know, was somebody else in the wrong? What are the ramifications of this? The guy flees the scene, which is the worst, most irresponsible thing you can do. Instead of holding that person accountable, no, now it's my fault because that guy hit me.
And I'm a white man, and he's a black man.
And I'm going to blame the cops who had nothing to do with any of it.
I mean, Rob, seriously, I wish we could read all 8 pages.
Yeah.
And on your own time, dear listener, I highly encourage you to go seek this out on Twitter. It's a Google Doc. I think Jesse has it on his own social media pages. And you can read it for yourself. It's truly wild. Here's the next excerpt. I had violated my own ethics by calling the police and screamed profanity at a scared child. I don't know if I've ever been more ashamed of myself, but it took many hours before I was even aware of that shame. The fear was that powerful. Based on the interaction itself, I had no reason to think that the kid who hit me intended to do so. It sounded like the collision had messed up his car. He was very quick to apologize, and he clearly felt scared based on his behavior. None of that speaks to attempted vehicular homicide or the behavior of a sadist, and yet he was willing to commit a much more serious crime in order to run away based on hearing the word police. We all respond to trauma and fear in ways that are not ideal.
So the question I would have is, let's say it had been a 16-year-old or 17-year-old or 18-year-old. I don't have any idea how old this kid actually
was. It is a teenager. We don't know, you know, whether he's a minor or
whatever. Let's say the kid had been white. Would the response be the same? That would be my question for him.
I would hope, because I think anybody who's involved in a hit-and-run crime, yes, you should have the police, white or black or in between.
No, but I'm saying, would his apology, would we be receiving this apology, this feel-bads? Like, is he genuinely sorry?
Or is he sorry that it was a black man?
I am always amazed at the depths to which people will stoop because they need to be in power in public office. And it sounds like this guy is just no different than the people. Because it's always with the socialists, right, or the Marxists or the communists. Like, the system is corrupt, and you need me in there to uncorrupt the system, and yet they behave in the exact same fashion, which it all comes back to needing to be in office and needing to be in power.
And before we wrap this up, here was his takeaway from the whole incident after he was the victim of a hit and run crime, you know, no two ways about it. He'd called the cops, and then he decides, well, you know, we're just gonna let it go. Quote, "The police had indeed been able to find the car in question and went to the owner's address to speak to her. Her teenage son had been driving, and he was afraid for his life based on the perceptions of law interactions with the police, how police can go for young black men. She was afraid for him for those same reasons. I dropped the criminal case and asked for written confirmation that nothing bad will happen to this driver or his mother. I shouldn't have immediately started talking about the police to the young man who was apologizing to me. I shouldn't have screamed at him as he drove away, committing a crime. I shouldn't have had a criminal report filed. I'm a police and prison abolitionist who has been an activist for my entire life, and I embarrassed myself and acted irrationally in the context of fear and adrenaline. No, you stupid... I can't use the words that I want to use right now. No, you acted rationally. Calling the police after being the victim of a crime is a very rational thing to do.
So the question I would have is, is he then saying he filed a false police report? Is he saying he wasted police resources?
Yeah, because he changed his mind. Ah, turns out I don't want you to prosecute the criminal. I just would have rather let him go. That was the correct course of action in the mind. It's so wild, and this is my city council member. Yeah.
You got to run against this guy next time, Ethan.
At the end of the day, though, and this is my takeaway before we wrap things up, no matter how much he wishes it weren't the case, now we know that when the moment of crisis came a knocking at old socialist Jesse Brown's door, he didn't call a social worker, he called the cops.
I'm throwing my hat in with Hatcher. That's our campaign slogan. I've already got it. You got to do it. We got to stand up against Jesse.
Hey, I'll do it as long as I got a fundraising source.
There we go.
Thanks for listening to Saturday Night on the Circle. Been a hell of a segment, Rob. Thanks for joining me.
I love it, brother. I love it.
Stay tuned to 93 WIBC.
Mario Andretti, Tony Kanaan, and Dario Franchitti. Champions who have shared their stories at Tales from the Track. This May, WIBC welcomes Indianapolis 500 winner and six-time IndyCar champion, Scott Dixon, to share his stories from the greatest track in racing. Monday, May 20th, Scott joins you and Hammer and Nigel for an evening of food, fun, and Tales from the Track. Brought to you by Relay Indiana. Tickets are available now at WIBC.com.
Greetings from R&R Agency, your Indiana health insurance pros. And a thank you to our loyal customers for making our agency a national sales leader for the seventh straight year. We recently saved a family of four over $500 monthly when compared to their ACA plan. You know it's still Obamacare, right? We've recently saved a 61-year-old retiring couple over $600 when compared to their COBRA plan. Breaking news, we are now able to offer health insurance to employer groups of all sizes. We're two of the largest insurers in the Midwest. We'll be here when you need us. Quoting my favorite president, what the heck do you have to lose? We can help. As always, God bless America, or at least what's left of her.
Call Ron or Terry at 317-563-0868. That's 317-563-0868. Or go to rragency.org. That's rragency.org. A health plan managed and chosen by you. Not the government.
Hey, Pat Sullivan here for Hope Plumbing. Spring has sprung and summer is right around the corner, which means family and friends and food galore. Do you know if your garbage disposal is ready for all that fun ahead? During the month of April, my friends at Hope Plumbing are offering a $100 off an upgraded garbage disposal. That's right, upgrade your current garbage disposal and get $100 off. Call Hope Plumbing or visit them online at hopeplumbing.com or give them a call at 641-HOPE and get ahead of the summer fun.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
Life is busy enough without plumbing problems. That's why you need an expert to fix it right the first time. Plumbing may not be pretty, but we're pretty darn good at it. And we'll always give you honest advice at a fair price. That's the L.D. Smith Plumbing Promise. Call today for $50 off any plumbing repair, big or small.
L.D. Smith Plumbing.
A dirty, stinking honest.
Jack Callahan, Iran launching multiple waves of explosive-laden drones at targets in Israel and some missiles. Israel's government reassuring its citizens.
We don't seek wars. We don't seek violence. But this concept that we're acting upon, that as the prime minister stated it, is if someone is trying to hurt us, somebody's threatening to hurt us, we will hurt them. We're not seeking wars again, but we will do whatever it takes to defend ourselves.
It's a spokesperson for Israel's Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu. Fox's Trey Yingston, Tel Aviv.
Everyone from the top military spokesman Daniel Hagari to Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu have come out with similar statements telling the public to remain calm and that Israel is prepared.
America is listening to Fox News.
Hey, it's Rob. Why did I choose We Grow Hair Indy to grow my hair back? Simple. They have the best results. Darren Andrews, as clinic director, can you tell us how you get those amazing results that we see on WeGrowHairIndy.com?
Yeah, thanks, Rob. Well, it's not just one thing that brings great results. At We Grow Hair Indy, there are three things. One, our microscopic evaluation helps us create the right treatment plan. Two, the best procedure can give you the best results. We're one of only two clinics in the entire country to offer the Artis Robotic FUE procedure and the multi-unit hair grafting procedure.
And I know number three is the follow-up care to make sure I'm getting the results I expected. Stay tuned, guys, and watch my hair grow back on my VIP page at WeGrowHairIndy.com. Call 317-522-2995 for your first step, a free evaluation. That's 317-522-2995. Get the results you want and grow your hair back.
Dents happen. There's a whole lot of stuff that can mess up the look of your vehicle. Don't paint your car. Go PDR with Killa Dent Removal. PDR is paintless dent removal that saves your factory finish and is way less invasive than traditional body shop repairs. And it's faster, too, sometimes same day. Google Killa Dent Removal and check out the reviews and photos. Then schedule your repair. Hail, baseballs, kids, fender benders, shopping carts, flying cows, angry exes, and anything else that leaves dents. Don't paint your car. Go PDR with Killa Dent Removal.
We may be thousands of miles apart, but we can still connect. And when we do, we make things better. At Child Fund, we connect children all around the world with what they need to grow up healthy, educated, and safe. Together, we co-create connections that help millions of children who live in poverty worldwide, and their families, and their communities, and you. Join us. Together, we can make the world a better place. Two small worlds at a time. Visit childfund.org to learn more.
You're listening to Saturday Night on the Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back to Saturday Night on the Circle. This segment, I'm going to talk about an interview where Michael J. Fox sat down and seemed to throw modern actors kind of under the bus, comparing the talents of actors in the 80s to today, and noting that there seems to be a little bit of drought of that in the current crop of actors. But first, I want to talk about trends in gaming. Now, producer Corbin, are you much of a gamer? You like to play on the old Xbox or PC? You have a Steam account?
I don't have PC, but I do have PlayStation and Xbox, and I do turn those on occasionally, but I'm not religiously glued to it. I like my TV shows too much.
Well, fair enough. I like games. I've played games since I was a lad. I started with the original N64 and then moved on to Xbox, and times were good. Now, there's a recent report in the industry that comes out of Newzoo, which shows that although the overall gaming and console market grew by 2.6% last year, overall, playtime decreased as gamers spent more time on a smaller list of old games like Fortnite and League of Legends. So most like of the top 10 across all consoles, whether it's a PlayStation, Xbox, or PC, in the top 10, many of the titles were dominated by games that are 6 or more years old, which I think is kind of interesting that they haven't come out with anything that tops Minecraft or League of Legends. Like, here were some of the titles that were in the top 10. Grand Theft Auto 5, Counter-Strike 2, Roblox, Minecraft, Rocket League, Apex Legends, Fall Guys, Valorant, and Call of Duty. Are you into any of those games?
Yeah, Grand Theft Auto, Call of Duty. Played a little bit of Minecraft back in the day, yeah.
Love Minecraft. I continue to play Minecraft today. Actually, Minecraft is where I'll play a lot of the time when I'm watching my TV shows. Mm-hmm. Like, I'll split the screen and then have the Minecraft going on and the TV show off to the side and take care of two things at one time. So that's how I like to enjoy it. But yeah, it's just interesting. More than 60% of the time was dedicated to games 6 years or older. Newzoo's data shows that 66 titles accounted for 80% of all playtime
in 2023, which is just is just so limited. But I think that in many instances, these game developers have lost touch with what the community actually wants. I mean, I'm not sure, Producer Corbin, if you saw kind of the debacle surrounding Spider-Man 2's release and what they did to Mary Jane Watson. They, you know, stuck her with an ugly stick. And they do that with a lot of heroines in particular these days. In fact, Stellar Blade, which is a game that is getting ready to come out, is in a bit of a controversy because a lot of these social justice warriors and the gaming journalists don't like the fact that they created an attractive avatar to play in this game. That, you know, there's this philosophy, you got to hit everybody with the ugly stick. It doesn't make sense and it doesn't connect with people. I think that's why there is this thirst for nostalgia. And like we were talking about Michael J. Fox, I think there's also a drought of talent. Many people who were making games even 20 years ago seem to understand the material better than modern developers do. And we see that with the debate surrounding the upcoming release of EA's Star Wars Outlaws. Another protagonist that got hit by the ugly stick, and it just, like, they're trying to stuff so many different mechanics in this thing that it comes out very generic and it doesn't resonate with what Star Wars used to be. And Disney has completely mutilated that franchise to the extent that now they're even talking about it on Joe Rogan. Of the Joe Rogan Experience, he had Matt Serra ranting about how Disney has just completely ruined the Star Wars experience. I agree. It's the same wokeism that has infiltrated gaming. It's why gamers are immersing themselves in older titles, six or more, or a decade old, and why the modern Disney hasn't resonated with people as much as the prequels or the original trilogy.
Here's the thing, like, it's not really Star Wars. It's just this new thing that they're using Star Wars, the Star Wars universe. And Star Wars is Luke Skywalker and Darth Vader, and that's it.
That's right.
It's Obi-Wan Kenobi, it's C-3PO, everything else, you're just stealing my money.
It's the truth.
The days,
pretty much what I think.
Like, listen, right now, Han Solo would be toxic. Han Solo was the f***ing P.I.M.P. How about when Han Solo was about to go with the f***ing carbonite? As a kid watching this, as a kid, oh, it's emotional. He's getting lowered into the carbonite. You don't know if he's going to survive this thing.
Right.
Chewie's sitting there upset. Lando's being a bit of a, you know, we're unsure about Lando. And Leia.
No, wait a minute.
I love Lando. He's a badass. But Leia goes to him, I love you. What does he say back? Watch this. What does he say back? Could you play it or no? Watch this.
He says, I know. Right? Huh?
Spoilers, Rogan. Watch this. Watch this. Look at that, first of all. Yeah. Watch this.
I love you.
I know.
Yes!
Gangster.
That's my Star Wars. He doesn't know if he's gonna live. He doesn't, and he does love her. He does. He's the man.
Yeah.
I love Han Solo. Ezra, take notes.
Matt Serra, former UFC welterweight champion, is also a nerd.
Now, I used to love Star Wars. Star Wars was my game back in the day. Are you feeling that too, Producer Corbin? Did you?
Oh yeah. Oh yeah.
Star Wars was the best. Now, were you more of an original trilogy or a prequels fan?
I really like Episode 2, but you can't beat the original trilogy with Luke and Darth Vader and Han and Leia and that whole, whatever it's called, surprise moment when it comes out in 6.
I think there was a purity in the process of creation that's lacking in a lot of modern Hollywood. It's lacking in games, and there's less of a connection to the craft and to the audience. Everything is filtered through a committee and it has to be processed by the, you know, these DEI officials to make sure, oh, well, you know, it don't want to offend anybody. And in the end result is you create this mush that nobody can emotionally resonate with. Something that Michael J. Fox was actually kind of talking about that being famous was tougher in the 1980s because you actually had to be talented. This was from his recent interview with People magazines, where he said that he was talking with a star, you know, another star, and they said, you know, you're 80s famous. And he thought, wow, that's cool, 80s famous. Like, right,
we're actually kind of different than modern movie stars. Like, I don't think there are modern movie stars in the same way that there were movie stars in the 1980s. You know, your Tom Cruises or your Stallones, you know, your Schwarzeneggers or your Candies or your other, you know, big draws. Names that were instantly recognizable. And if you saw their name on a movie poster, you knew that it was a must-watch film. Like, I don't think there's that same thing that goes on in today. And again, it's because there's less of a connection with the craft. There's less talent. We have truly devolved into idiocracy. Now, I was going to ask producer Jack this originally, but then I found out producer Corbin was filling in this evening. Now, you've got to have seen Idiocracy.
No.
You're kidding.
That is one that I have not seen.
Okay, well, then this isn't for naught then, because I figured producer Jack hadn't seen this, but I'm surprised you haven't. This came out in 2006, and it ended up being more prophetic than I think Mike Judge ever intended for it to be.
As the 21st century began, human evolution was at a turning point. Natural selection, the process by which the strongest, the smartest, the fastest reproduced in greater numbers than the rest, a process which had once favored the noblest traits of man, now began to favor different traits. Most science fiction of the day predicted a future that was more civilized and more intelligent. But as time went on, things seemed to be heading in the opposite direction, a dumbing down. How did this happen? Evolution does not necessarily reward intelligence. With no natural predators to thin the herd, it began to simply reward those who reproduced the most and left the intelligent to become an endangered species.
And as the intelligent quickly dwindle and die out and talent is drying up in the creative industries, I think that's why consumers are flocking to these older releases, older films, older stars, older games, because the crap they're coming out with now, it's just, it's not the same and it's not worth it. Thanks for listening to Saturday Night on The Circle. We'll be wrapping up coming up next, so stay tuned.
Mario Andretti, Tony Kanaan, and Dario Franchitti, champions who have shared their stories at Tales from the Track. This May, WIPC welcomes Indianapolis 500 winner and six-time IndyCar champion Scott Dixon to share his stories from the greatest track in racing. Monday, May 20th, Scott joins you and Hammer and Nigel for an evening of food, fun, and Tales from the Track. Brought to you by Relay Indiana. Tickets are available now at WIPC.com.
If you can plan barbecues and weddings, you can plan to protect yourself from a natural disaster. Sign up for local alerts, prepare an emergency kit, and make a family communications plan. Get started at ready.gov/plan.
Brought to you by FEMA and the Ad Council.
Hey, it's Hammer and Nigel for Window Nation. Now, you may hear the same offers from competing window companies. So why would you choose Window Nation over the rest? Window Nation is all about paying attention to detail. They measure their windows three times to ensure the proper fit. They have a 96% customer satisfaction rating, so they get the job done right the first time. They are experienced. Each installer has averaged over 10 years of experience.
You could have the best window in the world, but if it's not installed properly, it's not going to do you any good. Window Nation, they use top-of-the-line materials to ensure that your windows are installed perfectly the first time, and they back everything with a lifetime warranty. To go along with all these reasons, there's also this amazing deal. Buy two windows, get two for free. And there's no limit. Zero interest or payments for 24 months. You can't afford to miss this deal. Go with the experts. Go with Window Nation. 866-90-NATION or visit windownation.com to schedule your free in-home estimate.
There is no reason to live with achy joints. There's no reason to live with pain, and there's no reason not to seek out help. That help is at QC Kinetics in Eagle Creek, in Greenwood, and in Carmel. Under the leadership of National Medical Director Dr. Mitchell Scheinkup, QC Kinetics can help you get rid of joint pain with no surgery, no drugs, and no steroids. That's right. These are no longer your best options. Regenerative medicine at QC Kinetics is transforming lives with innovative treatments that deliver lasting results. We're talking natural biologics, using your body's own power to repair and restore damaged joint tissue. Talk to QC Kinetics today. Get a free consultation. They even have Saturday hours, so you have no downtime at work. Call QC Kinetics today and tell them Tony Katz sent you. QC Kinetics is in Eagle Creek, in Greenwood, and in Carmel. Call today. 317-559-PAIN. That's 317-559-PAIN. QC Kinetics. 317-559-PAIN.
Life insurance. Why are you putting it off? Can't afford it? Too much hassle? Think you don't need it? There's lots of excuses for putting off life insurance. But if you weren't there, who would pay the mortgage and other bills? With Ethos, you could be covered in 10 minutes and boom, family protected. Ethos, fast and easy online term life insurance. Up to $2 million in coverage with no medical exam. Some policies as low as a dollar a day. Answer a few health questions and get your free quote at getethos.com. That's getethos.com.
One in six seniors faces the threat of hunger, and millions more live in isolation. Drop off a hot meal and say a quick hello. Volunteer for Meals on Wheels by donating your lunch break at AmericaLet'sDoLunch.org. This message brought to you by Meals on Wheels America and the Ad Council.
You're listening to Saturday Night on The Circle on 93 WIPC.
Welcome back to the final segment of Saturday Night on The Circle, wrapping things up for the week. It's going to be a bit of a short segment because I went long in earlier segments of the show, but that's okay because we've had a lot of fun here this evening. Loved the conversation with Rob Kendall. And if you missed a moment, catch my podcast uploaded to WIBC.com and Saturday Night on The Circle.fireside.fm. This week, it just keeps happening. Now I think it's becoming a regular feature where important parts of airplanes just keep flying off. Whether it's rivets, whether it's doors, or now whether it's engine cowling. This was on a flight from Denver to Houston, and they had to return after parts of the engine were blowing off on the runway.
Let's go ahead and declare an emergency for Southwest 3695, and we'd like an immediate return. We got a piece of the engine cowling hanging off, apparently. Southwest 3695, roger that. Turn left heading 190 for the Denver via radar vector. Left turn heading 190, Southwest 3695.
It's time to stop. It's time to stop, okay? No more. I'm going to call Child Protective Services. It's time to stop.
I don't think that it's any coincidence that now that DEI policies are being implemented at Boeing and they're not selecting employees based on merit, now portions of the planes are flying off of the sky and these accidents are becoming a regular feature. We're going to have more plane crashes, but at least they will be more diverse and inclusive plane crashes than ever before. Hey, thanks for listening to the show, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks for spending your time with me on a Saturday evening. It's quite valuable, and every moment that you share with me is quite precious. I leave you with my parting words of wisdom, as always, wherever you are, whoever you're with, whatever you're doing. Remember that life is a state of mind. See you next week.
Here from Bats R Us with the three big